Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video we'll discuss alter command. The alter table command is used to change definitions of existing tables. We can add a column, delete a column, modify the definition of existing column, change the name of existing columns. It is a DDL command. Now we'll discuss how to add a single column to an existing table. Syntax is alter table table name, add column name with data type. Here we are having a course table and we are adding date of admission, which is of date type. We have to write alter table course add DOA, which is the column name, and date is the data type. A new column will be added with null values for all rows currently in the table. We can also add multiple columns to an existing table. Syntax to add multiple columns is alter table table name, add column name 1 with data type, comma column name 2 with data type. Here in the table course we are adding student enrolled and teacher name. Student enrolled is of integer type of data and teacher name is a variable character. It is possible to add several new columns separated by commas. In course table, student enrolled and teacher name will be added with null values for all rows currently in the table. Now we will see alter table command practically. First of all, we have to keep the password of MySQL. As discussed in our previous videos, we have to create a database. Then we have to use the database so that we can create as many tables as we want. Create database, employ to create a database. Now we'll open employee database. For that we have to write use employee. Now we'll create a table EMP. We'll increase the font size of MySQL command prompt. For that we have to just click on the white area, and whatever size is required we can choose. For that we have to write create table EMP. EMP code is of data type integer, which is a primary key. Name is varchar20 and stipend is integer. Now the table EMP is created with three field names: employee code, name and stipend. Now we'll insert few datas to it. For that we have to write insert into EMP values, as we have declared EMP code as primary key. We cannot have duplicate values. Similarly, we can create more rows by using the same syntax, but we have to change the datas. First data is 1J2000, second data is 2Amit3000, and third data is 3Aman3500. To see the datas inserted In the table, we can run the command select star from emp. We can see the three datas inserted into the table. Now three rows are inserted. We will run alter table name, add stream which is of variable type, and it can store up to 15 characters. Now we can describe emp to see stream field name is available or not. Now you can see that stream column name is there and its data type is varchar. We can add multiple columns to a table also. For that we have to write alter table name, add average marks float 5,2, comma grade which is of character type and it can store one character. So far we have added three columns: streams, average marks and grade. We can add as many columns as we want. We have to just separate them by commas and we have to write the data type of each column. Now we have described the EMP table. You can see three column names are there: stream, average marks and grade. We can remove table components by using drop method. This command is used to delete a particular column from an existing table, and it can also delete primary key and foreign key. Syntax is alter table name, drop column name. Here in the table course we are deleting date of joining. Now we'll see practically how it works. To show you the datas inside the table, I am just writing select star from emp. The field names which we have entered just now contains null values. Now we'll delete one column from it: alter table emp, drop column grade. It will delete grade field from emp table. Now we'll see select star from emp will not have grade column. We can use modify clause to change data type, default value, order of column, size, not null column constraint. Syntax to change the data type is alter table name, modify column name with data type. Here I am changing the course name to varchar 25. Now we'll see practically how it works. Write alter table name, modify. We want to change stream field name which contains 15 characters. Now we'll change it to contain only 10 characters. For that we have to write alter table emp, modify stream, varchar 10. Now we'll describe emp to see the changes. As you can see, stream has worker 10 now. We can also change the order of column. For that we have to write alter table table name, modify name worker 20 first. As you can see, name will be the first column of the table. In this way we can change the order of table. Now we will run the select query to see how the order of the table changed. As you can see, name is the first column name in the table. We can also change the order again. For that we have to write alter table emp modify emp code, which is of type integer, and we place it to first position again. Sometimes we need to change the name of one of our columns. For this we can use change clause. Syntax is alter table table name, change old column name space new column name with data type. We have to give the complete column description with the new column name. Alter table emp change name to emp name worker 25. It will change name to emp name. If you will run select star from emp, you can see now column name has changed to emp name. Now we have executed successfully change name to emp name by using alter command. Hope this video is beneficial to you. Thanks for watching the video.